then I really know we can't do anything. A person who's seen Angel Israel, your person have to go. But if you've not seen Angel Israel, this means you are not too old for it. I am a female, that is not a valid. For female, it is as well. If for men, it is well. For female, male. Well, alhamdulillah, the condition is that for female, if they come to take the course, they have to come with a mahram, or somehow, at least they should be accompanied by a mahram. Any female is not allowed in a room, no matter with a scholar, with a pious, with a Sufi, with a righteous person. When they are alone, if it's a non-mahram female, no matter how many, it is not allowed in Sharia. No, it's no use I saying, you are my sister, or you are my daughter, like my daughter. No, my daughter is the daughter who is actually biologically my daughter. My sister is the biological. Others are sisters in Islam, but they are not, they are non-mahram. So sisters should specially take care, don't visit, no matter any person claims to be pious, righteous, or Sufi. If they say, come alone, or we will meet you in a room or a hotel, no, that's not allowed. I want to follow the crowd. Well, that's what some people say. We want to follow what others are doing. Well, if you follow the crowd, you like get lost in the crowd as well. So, kehte na Urdu mein bheed chal. People are actually just like the lambs or sheep. They're just following the crowd. You don't want to follow. You have been sent a messenger, the most venerable of the creation, Rasulullah. You have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasul illa li yuta'a bi-Allah. The messenger is sent to be followed, not the crowd. Who is in the crowd? It might be Shaitan, it might be Namrud, it might be Pharaoh and their followers. So don't follow the crowd, follow the truth and follow the righteous path. This is a very dangerous attitude that others are doing, and I will do it as well. More people live in Bangladesh than here Muslims. We never say if there are more people there, let's go there. So we don't follow the crowd in worldly matters. Only in religious matter we say, okay, it's okay, it's time to pass on. But in worldly matter, the other person have a good car, good house, we all want it. We don't say millions, if there are more poor people in the world than rich, so it's better we be poor as well. So we don't follow the crowd in that respect. But following the crowd in respect of deen is no other than actually deception. It will hamper my social and worldly activities. It does not hamper any social worldly activities, a lawful activity, but it enhances, it further makes it better. Your relationship with your wife, your husband, your family, with the society, with non-Muslims, with Muslims, it makes them better, not at them. I will lose friends. Well, if they're evil, you better lose them. If they're good, you won't lose them. Alhamdulillah, they will come close to you. But shaitan and shaitanic friends, yes, it's better to lose them. Allah has not given me tawfiq. That is a false myth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tawfiq means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the time. You are living in the space, you have the intellect, you have the knowledge, and you have the freedom of will. That is known as tawfiq. You have the guidance. You think that Allah is keeping you back from Jannah? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given tawfiq to everyone. Now if we don't use that tawfiq, then it's up to him. Now they read the verse in the Quran, Allah says, وَمَنْ شَاءَ يُؤْمِنْ, whoever wants, let him believe. وَمَنْ شَاءَ يَكْفُرْ, and whoever wants to become unthankful or disbelieve, they should disbelieve. Tawfiq is not the name of justice. As one of the scholars said, that if you, a husband is working, and he comes home at evening time, and he buys all grocery in his house for his wife, children, and everything, and he comes back, and the wife, she said, have you cooked any food today? I'm very hungry, I've been on the work all day, very tired, very frustrated, stressed day. She said, I've not got tawfiq to cook the meal. I've got, although everything, the grocery is there, she said, I did not get the tawfiq today. Will that person just sit there, okay, if you haven't got the tawfiq, okay, we'll have dinner or outside. Or that person will say that tawfiq is that I earned money, I brought the grocery, there's a fridge, there's a cooker, we have a running water, gas, that is the tawfiq. So that's how many people interpret tawfiq as well. Shaitan will be displeased. Well, really, you should not be worried if he is the only person who will be displeased when you come close to Allah and His Messenger. Only person. And the person, people who follow him, they will be displeased. So don't worry about them. Finally, verse of Quran, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ سَرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Say, O my those slaves who have transgressed against yourself, sinned, committed kufr, whatever. لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Do not despair of the mercy of Allah. إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا. Truly Allah will forgive all your actions. He is the ever forgiving, the most merciful. And the verse continues, verses, Allah SWT says, اتبعوا, turn to your Lord and submit to Him before punishment comes upon you, for then you cannot be held. So Allah SWT is saying, there is mercy. I will have mercy on you, but for those people who want to turn to me, it's not those who continuously want to be rebellious and then say, Allah will have mercy on me. That is called umniya. That is wishful thinking, a deceit. Then Allah SWT says, follow the best that has been sent down to you, which is Quran, which is the Sunnah, which is Rasulullah SAW, from your Lord before the punishment comes upon you suddenly when you are not expecting it. Imagine the people who got caught in tsunami. Did they have time to repent? People who were caught in the floods in America, in states, have they actually been given time? No, people who, in thousands, people are killed. So this shows that no government, alhamdulillah, no on the face of the earth have ultimate control. The one who claims to be superpower, just few, you may say, the wind, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to use, the nature, as they say, nature is whom? Nature is controlled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So only superpower is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all actually should submit to Him. We are very, very vulnerable sitting on this earth from the forces of nature or anything, and we should try to use this time to fulfill the rights of Allah and rights of the people, Muslims, non-Muslims, animals, the environment, and fear the punishment which comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lest anyone should say, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if, and lest anyone, you don't become that person who will say, alas for me for neglecting what was due to Allah. And taqul ya hasrata ala ma farratu fi jambillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't become one of these persons. And being one of the ridiculers, meaning a ridicule, a laugh at religious people, the prophets and the messengers, they know nothing about this world. And they know nothing, it's just stories. Well, you will know it is a story when Angel Israel arrives. Or when the death comes, it will be a new story. Or lest they say, Allah SWT then said, if only antaqul law anna Allah hadani. This is the myth which I said about Tawfiq. Now Allah SWT don't say this and be one of those who will say, if only Allah had guided me, I would have had taqwa. Law anna Allah hadani lakum. You are blaming on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is not guiding you. Allah SWT says, don't be of this. Or lest they should say, when He sees the punishment or death, if I only could have another chance so that I could be a good doer. This is the verse translation of the verse of the meaning of Quran. And then Allah SWT says, Kalla, no. No, this all are falsehood. What you are saying that Allah had guided, if Allah did not guide you or anything. The fact is that my signs came to you, which is the Prophet's messenger, the Quran, and the guidance came to you, but you denied them. You denied them. فَكَذَّبْتَ بِهَا. You denied them. And what's the fact about arrogant? I know better. I know how to live my life. It is my life. Your life, you create yourself? No. Life given by someone else in that Allah. And you were arrogant, wastakbarta, and were one of the disbelievers. So this is also Surah Zumar, verse 53-55. And conclusion is very, very short, in one sentence, and something for you to think about. When preparation meets opportunity, one finds favor with the Lord of the universe. I'll just give you a hint. This life, there are many things which come in there, but this life is opportunity, and preparation is the imaan and good deeds. They both have to meet to actually find favor and find success. Their opportunities of jobs comes in the newspapers, in the news, but if you're not prepared, you don't apply, how are you going to get that job? So remember this, only when a preparation meets opportunity, one finds success for salvation, or one finds the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this. So opportunity is there, Allah has given you, sent you, life is given to you, guidance is given to you. Only lacking is the preparation part. So that's my conclusion, and inshallah I will be taking any question, any brothers who have written or sisters. And thereafter, anyone individually wants to ask anything, inshallah, I will also be available for that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me if I've said anything wrong or offended anyone.